Hey filmmaker, Chung Dha here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to edit like Sam Kolder. So first things first, how his video always starts is with a title. The actual font that he uses is the surfing capital. However, what I found, this one is really heavy for any computer. So even my computer has really a big issue trying to load this font in Photoshop or in Premiere. Just try a different font that is the same. But for the sample, I'm going to use a different font. Make a new title, default still. And I'm going to type in Sony RX 100 Mark III. And we're going to use a brush-like font. And I have some already in here. I'll go with the cinnabar. This one looks good. Make it actual white. Here, center it. And here, just drag it in the timeline. So his title always starts with a brush type, but it's moving and in a special way. In the description below, a link to the preset to the effect. So there is a full tutorial on that preset, but I'm going to show you how I apply it here. Title, logo, and wiggly text. And this will add that effect that he also got, like with his title wiggling. Then of course he is pretty famous for his transitions. So here we already have one using the Luma fade. And for what I do it, or how I made my preset, is called Luma matte. And also in the link below there be a link to it. Want it to be 10 frames, so I hold down shift and arrow key twice to get to 10 frames. So here we have 10 frames overlapping, and here I'm going to use command K or control K on Windows to cut it, and hold down alt to copy this layer. Here I have the Luma matte transition, and the free, I want it to be from light to dark. So LD, the free is layer 3, and I need light to dark, and mix that, and then here track matte light to dark. So what happens, it's actually the lightest part is fading away, showing the video in the background. You can see the results of the sky going away first and then the building. The other transition that he uses is called smooth transition or a zoom blur. I'm going to show you a different method than the actual tutorial. The actual tutorial is in the link below, but you can actually use this method to using the same preset. So in transition folder, we have smooth transition, and you want this to be 10 frames, cut it here also 10 frames, going to use the zoom in, and for the zoom in, I need to add the tile, transition tile on the second video. Now select both clips and nest them together with the right mouse click and choose nest, press OK. And then we are going to add the zoom in. It's quite a heavy set, heavy transition, so trying to view this in real time, it's going to be quite laggy. So that was the zoom in transition. And also with that smooth transition, we have also like a left right. Here also going to cut 10 frames, and here with 10 frames. And we want it to go from left to right. And here both of them, we add the transition tile, select both of them, and we add a nesting, and then we add the left to right. So this is that left and right transition, which is really heavy on even my laptop to do that. So you can see it pushing it. And what else do we have? We have also the spin transition. That would be actually quite nice here. So here, cut to 10. Here, we also cut to 10. And for the spin, also both of them needs the transition tile effect on them. And then we select both to nest them. And we add the clockwise spin for this one. And that is cool. Okay, what Sam Kolder also is known for is having like small art drawings on his videos, and it's sometimes really quick, really animated. So we are going to do it here. First thing, you need to make a bin and then double click on it, and actually going to close it here and just double click on it. It will open a new tab and drag it up here, so it makes it easier for yourself. And making a new bin is just here below with new bin. And we are going to make a new title here. And what we want to do is want it to be like few lines flying out of here. So I'm going to just use the line tool instead. Select all of them, make it some equal thickness, make it pure white, make it rounded ends. And also one thing I've got to tell you is here in preferences, in general, make the still image duration 2 frames. So it's actually the titles that you make is actually showing in 2 frames. It makes the animation a little bit easier. So, and now make a new one. And this one is a little bit easier than the rest. Just going to hold on Alt and just going to make this bigger. And it will look like it actually flies open, or actually the lines are actually moving out. Make another one. So this tool actually makes a new title based on the one you are working on, so it doesn't make it really different, or actually just makes a new copy but still have the same lines. This we're going to make it even bigger. I think for 3 frames this animation should be enough. Oh, it's actually 2 frames. I have to make another one. Oh, forgot to click it there, and then make another one. And okay, so the reason why this bin is so that you can drag all 3 of them, or even if you draw more for more frames or longer animation, they be in the same folder, so instead of making a mess in the other folders. So these three I can just drag and drop, and you can see quickly a line art animation. So that is pretty much it. This is a quick and easy way to do this line art. And if you find these lines to be too straight, you can actually go nest them and then drag and drop the wiggly text effect on them to make them more wiggly shaped. As you can see, they are more in a wiggly shape instead of being too straight. A different kind of animation. This one is quite easy. Show a little bit more interesting styles. Still in this folder. And so I'm going to use the pen tool for this one, because I want it to go through or make more interesting shapes. This one round, this one pure white. So every time you make a new title, you have to press that bin, otherwise it will save it in a different bin or a different place. Going to move this up. Try to move it in a way that it still overlaps. Okay, so that was quickly drawn. Now select all of these, and we're going to drag these in place and you can see another quick animation, and just all is quick way drawn. And to make these also more squiggly, you can select all of these, right mouse click and nest them, and also add this wiggly to make it more wiggly. So that was it, how to edit like Sam Kolder in Premiere Pro. To get all the effects and presets, there are links in the description below to tutorials where everything is fully explained, and also how to download and install the presets. So if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more upcoming videos, please subscribe. If you have any questions, please comment below, and I'll see you the next time. Bye bye.